I'm Klaus Lynge from Odeon, and in this short video I'll show you how you make an animation in Odeon and make use of it in a PowerPoint presentation. We have these four icons up here related to animations. You can capture a single image, a sequence of images, each n number of seconds, and you can change and save your animation into a GIF animation file. And finally, you can set some options on related to capturing of images. I opened this options and you can see we can decide which window to capture from, the program window, the active window, including its title bar, or as we'll do in this case, graphics area of the active window. You can also decide how often you want to capture an image when you capture a series of images. So we capture an image each 200 milliseconds here. Then we should open the window you want to capture from. And it's a good idea if you give the size of this graphic area the same size as you want it to appear as inside your animation. Otherwise, titles and numbers, text might appear a little bit awkward inside your animation. I want to make use of balls with a diameter of 2 millimeters in my animation, and let's see, this is what I want to have in my animation. And then we go up here and start our capturing, and we start the animation. Now I want these balls to be radiated vertically in my animation. And when you're satisfied that you captured the right amount of images, you can stop your capture and you can change the film rule. That is to say, you want to save this animation as a file and it will be saved as an animated GIF file. I'll call this file 3D billiard. So we have an animation, and the Odeon asks if you want to edit this GIF animation, and that can be a very good idea. We have the Odeon GIF animation for that purpose, and it opened now. You can see that each of these frames have a delay assigned to it, meaning that it will be displayed for that amount of milliseconds in your animation. Now, first of all, I want to delete these frames where the balls are radiated horizontally. I don't like them. So we delete them. The first, all of the animations I want to have displayed for around 100 milliseconds, except for the first animation up here. I want it to be displayed for a little longer. I want to display it for 2000 milliseconds, i.e. 2 seconds. And the last frame I want to display for 1 second, that is 1000 milliseconds. Then we should save our animation again, and we should also finalize it, optimize and save. When you do that, it's not possible to edit everything again in this animation, but the benefit is that it will be smaller when saved. So now I will save it, and you can see that it was reduced to around half a megabyte of data, which is not too bad in today. So this is our animation, and we should fill it into our PowerPoint presentation, and that's what I'll do now. We have PowerPoint here, and what you do is you insert an image. So this is an image. It's because this is an animated GIF animation, and that is considered an image file. So this is the 3D billiard file I just saved onto the desktop, and here we have it, and let's see what happens when we press the dash show. So we have the 2 seconds of delay, and then we have the balls being emitted from the source, and we have a nice animation inside our PowerPoint presentation, and you can use it and combine it with images and other WAV files and so on, and whatever you want in your PowerPoint presentation. Thank you for taking the time to watch this small video on how to create animations in Odeon and make use of them in a PowerPoint presentation.